Hey boo, hey, it's Diva, and I'm here once again with another message. I hope that you guys are enjoying this day. We're gonna go ahead and start off with prayer, and then we're gonna go and get into the message, okay? Period. Our Father, we thank you so much for this time and this day. We ask that you would come through and bless us. Allow this message to come through as smooth as possible. Release your mighty warring and guarding angels all around us. Use me to give this message to your people and help them to receive it the way that you would have them to. Also, Lord, I ask that you would anoint me right now and allow the Holy Spirit to come into this place. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Type amen in the comments, guys. Type amen. Listen to me. You ought to be glad. You got to be happy when people begin to persecute you. And I know that might sound crazy, but I'm telling you, when people persecute you and begin to talk about you and lie on you, God says, be happy. Be glad about it. Because it's going to be some things that you're going to receive just for being a great person, being chosen, being connected to God by not reacting off of their silly foolery, okay? Period. Listen to me. I know that you guys know that there are many people that will be around you thinking that once you start that business, once you write that book, once you tell them I'm gonna become this or that, they may persecute you. And a lot of times it's the people closest to you. Half the time it's because they don't want you to be better than them. But that's another story for another day, okay? So listen to me. I'm here to tell you that God wants you to be happy about the things that are happening in your life, whether you're being persecuted, whether you're being counted out, counted the, what they call it, the black sheep, whether you're counted out, whether they didn't give you that promotion at your job, whatever it was for you, be happy. Because I was reading here in Matthew 5:11, it says, God blesses you when people mock you and persecute you and lie about you and say all sorts of evil things against you because you are my followers. Do you hear me? They say all kinds of lies. He says, be happy about it. He says, be happy about it. And then he also says, be very glad. He didn't just say be glad. He says, be very glad. Be very glad. And you want to know why you got to be very glad? It's because for a great reward awaits you in heaven. Right. Rewards. Just for enduring these fools. Okay. And it says, and remember, the ancient prophets were persecuted in the same way. Listen, he says, remember what happened back in the day. Not only was the ancient prophets, but also Yeshua. He was persecuted in the same way. You know, they didn't believe him. He was not the son of God to them. You know, he was just whoever. You the carpenter's son. You ain't nobody. You just a little boy. I know who your parents is. I know who you is. Your parents just this. Your parents wasn't like that. So how you gonna be like this? How you the son of God if you the son of Mary and Joseph? Make it make sense. That's what they thinking. See, they thinking mind like 3D. Yeshua is letting it be known, baby. I was birthed in the spirit. I was, you know, I'm spirit, okay? And they persecuted him. They did him in a worse way, baby. They did him in, not knowing that he was going to rise again, though. Y'all know that. Y'all know that. So that's in the same way with you. And y'all saw how they did Joseph and his brothers. Baby, Joseph told them, baby, I had a dream. I had a dream. I was running things. You know, I was doing everything. Like, I was here for y'all. Y'all had to come to me and beg to me, okay? I had the dream. Y'all know they tried to get rid of this dude. Then they gonna sell him. They sold their own brother to get him away from his father. Not knowing that the very people they sold him to was the very people that rose him up, counted him in, gave him a blessed life. They ain't do nothing but put him in his blessed place. They didn't do nothing but help him receive his rewards. Just like you're going to receive. Just remember, the Lord says for a great reward, not just a reward. He said a great reward awaits you in heaven. And y'all know, on earth as it is in heaven, as we say in the Lord's Prayer. So anything that's in heaven is on earth for us because we prayed about it. Do you hear me? We prayed all about it. So everything that you're enduring because they didn't want to see you make it. They couldn't see that you would be an author of a book, that you would minister the gospel, that you would use the gifts that were given to you and be blessed by it and bless other people, that you would be the head and not the tail, above and not beneath. See, they couldn't believe it. But they're going to be all right. God says a great reward awaits us. A great reward awaits us. Just for us. And it's here on earth as it is in heaven. Remember that. So don't worry about them. Don't worry about them. They're going to be all right. Don't be upset. Don't get your panties all in a bunch. You don't have to trip off of them. You just keep doing your thing. You keep writing that book. Matter of fact, right, go ahead and finish the second book, the third book, the fourth book. Open that business. Ask for that promotion. I don't care how long you've been there. See, when it comes to God, he could change up the thing for you. They might say you got to be there for 90 days, but God can say, look, I can give you more. I can make them give you more. Because that's what he does. He changes everything just for us because we are obedient to him. Because we are rooted and grounded in him. Let them talk about you. Let them persecute you because you know they're going to say all kinds of evil stuff. They're going to talk about you to the very people that you talk to too. Y'all got the same friends. Y'all in the same family. They're going to be in front of you saying something to you in front of them. Then as soon as you leave, girl, who she thinks she is? Girl, dude, did you hear this man? Like, for real? That's what they gonna do. But God says, be happy, be glad, be very. He didn't say be glad. He said, be very glad. Be very glad that it's happening. Because you're gonna be blessed. And y'all know what we always say. We always say this word that comes from the word of God. God prepares a table before you in the presence of your enemies. So let them do it. Let them talk. And it's just as you're sitting at that table, they're going to be talking then. But their mouth going to be dropped. Pick up your mouth. Type in the comments. Pick up your mouth. Pick up your mouth. Pick up your mouth. Because they're going to be looking in awe. Like, I thought what we said and we did actually worked. It worked for them. It worked for the ones that wasn't rooted and grounded in God because they believed they dumb tail. I'm just saying. But it didn't work in God because God's like, I'm the one who has the final say. I'm the one who's doing it. So why are you worried? He says, don't worry. Don't worry about tomorrow because he's taking care of it already. Type in the comments, I trust God. I trust God. I was at church yesterday and they talked about when you step out in the morning and you step out the door, shout out loud, I trust God. That's exactly what I did. I said, I don't even care. I'm going to shout it to them. Look, the dogs start barking. You think I care? No, because I do trust God. I trust him. And that's what I'm encouraging you to do. Trust him that he's going to change your situation. That even though they talked about you, even though the words that they spoke to you went out into the earth, into the universe, God is the God over the universe. So it cannot penetrate if he's protecting you. It cannot penetrate if he's the one who has the final say in your life. So hear me when I say this. You are blessed beyond measure. You're protected. You're underneath the shadow of the Almighty. And the table that you have, they gonna be talking when they looking, but exactly, they got to look. They gotta watch you eat. They gotta watch you be blessed. They gotta watch you receive that promotion. They gotta watch you write that book. When that book becomes published and it shows up on their timeline, honey, they gotta see it. When you're doing the book signings, they gotta see it. They gonna have to watch while you eat, okay? Because the blessings of the Lord maketh rich and he has no sorrow to it. So everything that they're doing ain't got nothing to do with you. Trust and believe. So everybody that believes them, everybody that's in their little group, that's listening to them, let them be over there. Because you're going to be blessed and rich. Rich in his glory, rich in wealth, rich in abundance, rich in whatever it is that he has for you. on earth as it is in heaven. For a great reward awaits you in heaven. On earth as it is in heaven. So be blessed. I thank you guys for watching. Please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And be encouraged. Share this video. And let others be encouraged by it as well. I love you guys. Peace and blessings. Mwah.